Hello, anatomy students. In this video, I'm going to explain the major arteries of the head and neck and the direction of blood flow through them. These are the arteries that supply oxygenated blood, that's oxygen-rich blood, to the brain, eyes, facial muscles, neck, pharynx, and larynx. From the left ventricle, blood moves through the aortic valve, up the ascending aorta, and continues into the arch of the aorta, which is also called the aortic arch. The brachiocephalic trunk is the first and largest branch off the aortic arch, supplying the right side of the head and neck, that's the cephalic part of its name, and the upper arm, that's the brachio part of its name. There is only one brachiocephalic trunk, which is why it's not given a right or left designation. It directs the blood up and over the superior vena cava. The trunk divides into the right common carotid artery and the right subclavian artery. The right subclavian artery extends as a continuation of the brachiocephalic trunk. It doesn't actually branch off. It's the same vessel. It's just given a different name as it moves through a different body region. Its name refers to its location under the clavicle, and it branches into several arteries at the base of the neck and supplies the right upper limb. One of those branches is the right vertebral artery. A major branch of the right subclavian artery before it becomes the right axillary artery at the armpits. The right vertebral artery rises through the neck, passing through the transverse foramina of the cervical vertebrae. It then moves into the skull through the foramen magnum to the bottom of the brain. From there, it merges with the left vertebral artery to form the basilar artery, which runs under the base of the brain. Several arteries branch off the basilar, which supply different regions of the brain, including the posterior cerebrum, cerebellum, pons, and the inner ear. The other branch of the brachiocephalic trunk is the right common carotid artery, a large diameter artery that supplies the right side of the head and neck. It divides near the superior border of the larynx into the right external carotid artery and the right internal carotid artery. The external carotid arteries are the more superficial of the two branches and serve as the major suppliers of blood to all of the structures of the head and neck, except the brain. These include the skin, muscles, bones, joints, and connective tissues. The internal carotid arteries are the deeper of the two branches, entering the cranial cavity through the carotid foramen. They then produce a number of branches inside the cranial cavity. This is a complicated area containing many anastomoses, with several arteries branching off the internal carotids to form the cerebral arterial circle, also known as the circle of Willis, located at the base of the brain. The circle of Willis provides alternate detours for blood flow to the brain in case arteries become blocked or damaged, as well as helping to equalize blood pressure to the brain. Going back to the aorta, the left common carotid artery is the second artery that branches directly from the arch of the aorta and supplies the left side of the head and neck. It shares the same branching and blood distribution pattern as the right common carotid artery. It divides into the left external carotid and the left internal carotid artery. The left subclavian artery is the third and final branch off the arch of the aorta. It carries blood to its branch, the left vertebral artery, and then continues on as the axillary artery before it leaves the trunk and moves into the left upper arm. This pattern is similar to the right subclavian artery.